Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's Tomb, and oh my god, it's a gameplay that's not on raid again. See, I told you guys, you guys really don't understand how easy it is for me to get gameplay on raid. The people I play against, I think I've got like a week's worth of raid gameplay, but you guys are going to be watching an 89 on the map Overflow. I'm going to be using the Warthog, the Lodestar, and the VTOL Warship. And I get a bunch of senseless deaths in this gameplay, and you guys will get a chance to see exactly what those are. And I was actually going to talk about that in this game, and raging, and like deaths that you can't really help. Like, there's certain deaths in here. One is coming up right now, actually, where I'm pushing up in the back of the spawn. I know we got these guys spawn trapped, and I'm playing solo. I do play with colorblind assist on, but look at this kid. So I thought that I would be able to take him. I should have just run away from that gunfight, but look at what he had. He had a silenced LMG with the target finder and attack insertion. Now, you guys will see him two or three more times in this gameplay, and he kills me off on my streaks every time. Now, I could have helped that first death. I could have shot him, I could have pulled away, I shouldn't have gone back, I shouldn't have got greedy, but I felt as though that I'd be able to take that kid. And he had a better gun, he had a better sight, a cheaper sight, and a more bullshit weapon. But it's beside the point. The fact is, he's in a better position. I shouldn't have pushed that gunfight. I should have, you know, sat back. I should have waited. I should have at least waited for my health to regenerate instead of popping around that corner and then giving myself another death that I really didn't need. And that's just one of them things. It's Call of Duty does that to you because you want to get that kill. You want to be like, oh my god, I'm gonna kill this kid. I'm gonna kill this kid. I'm gonna kill this kid, because it's that vindictiveness. It's that Call of Duty preys on the revenge and the vindictiveness of the human, human behavior. I mean, like, if you get killed by somebody on a kill streak, you want payback. If somebody kills you more than twice, you're gonna want payback. So the minute that you get a chance to get payback, you're gonna seize that chance. But see, the problem is with that, that's when somebody else can come in and kill you. And that's how people tend to get you off your game when you play COD. It's like, if somebody tries to kill you in this game and you're on a kill streak and they actually succeed, you get pissed. So you go try and hunt them down. You try and slay the enemy team, and you end up forgetting that you're here to win, but you're also here to get a good score line. That's what I try to do when I play Call of Duty. If I see that I can't get a good score line at the end of the gameplay, I decide to go for the W. Because the W is all that matters. If I can get both, then I go for both. And that's how you're supposed to play. You're not just solely supposed to play. It's like, oh, it's all about kills, it's all about this, it's all about this. No, you want to get the W, and you want to do it with the least amount of deaths as humanly possible. And that just goes into thinking about the decision making that you have to do in COD. I mean, I know that this is a basic arcade first person shooter, but you know, there are things that you have to learn. Rush routes, where people are going to be, how the spawns work. There are certain things that you need to know when you play COD if you want to do well. And I kind of see how other communities look down at us. Like, I think it's funny how other communities look down at COD and call it childish, and how MLG and GB stuff is stupid, but we say the same thing about them. Maybe it's just all around, just the, you know, we all have that same thing. But look, here you see, that's the same kid who was sitting in the back of the spawn on the other side of the map. He was sitting over here. Now, I had completely forgotten that he had attack insertion, and I should have kept running to my left, and I would have avoided this death here. But this is the definition of a bad player. This is a definition of a Wings of Redemption subscriber, or a Wings of Redemption himself. He ends up losing a game because he sits in the back of the map with a target finder going 5-3 with two defends or freaking two captures. And here again, I was on another streak. My teammate blocked the door. And look who kills me yet again. Still sitting in the back of the spawn. Still camping. And he barely killed me. See, those are those deaths that you can't avoid. I couldn't have avoided that death. I wasn't even thinking about that kid again. And then he's like 9-3. I think he gets one more kill at the end of this gameplay. My point is, there are certain things you can avoid, and there are certain things that you can't avoid. But those two deaths, I could have. And here you see me coming back here to murder this kid, but he's just sitting in the corner. Bouncing Betty, attack insertion. It's such a joke, man. But look, all you gotta do is think when you play. Think about people's routes. Think about where are people going to be? Where do people like to sit? And figure out a way to counter where they're camping. So I hope you guys enjoyed this commentary. I hope you enjoyed the gameplay. If you guys like my voice, if you guys like this gameplay, if you like my channel, go ahead and click that thing in the top right hand corner and go ahead and hit that subscribe button. If you want to see a previous video, click that thing in the bottom right hand corner. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter. I'm Toom. I'm out. Peace.